What's up, guys? It's Clydeokre. I'm back with some League of Legends, and I'm playing on Howling Abyss, Legend of the Poro King. Now, as some of you might have noticed, I was gone for 3 months, so I pretty much stopped recording videos again, and I have an excuse for it this time. My laptop actually just died out, like the hardware failed on me while I was recording, and that just prevented me from making videos. So I decided to just, instead of repairing my laptop, which I did, and keep recording with it, I decided to just repair my laptop, leave it as it is, and just, you know, use it as a regular laptop, and just decide to go ahead and build a PC. So that's what I did. I just, you know, pretty much just saved up money and got all the computer parts that I needed, and I was able to build a PC, and here it is, and that's how I am able to make this video. And yeah, so alright, so in this game I'm playing Sion and Legend of Poro King, and I'm playing with my friends. There's Teemo, Lucian, Poppy, and Soraka, and their team has Jace, Kog'Maw, Nidalee, and Varus. And I don't know who the fifth one is, I forgot, but doesn't matter. Anyway, so for this game, this is actually the first game that I've played with all of these guys in such a long time, because I haven't been able to ever since my laptop like got all that problems. I kind of stopped playing with them for a bit, and I was focusing on school, so yeah. So over here it looks like we're doing pretty bad, because their fifth person is Diana. Okay, so we're doing pretty bad because, as you notice, that they have more poke than us. I think, yeah, like four of them can poke. Kog'Maw can poke with his Q and E, but then as soon as he hits 6, you know, you'll know what he does when he hits 6. He does that, that fire, not fireball, but his stupid sniping skill with his ultimate. So they have 4 pokes. Oh, Diana can poke too with her Q. And we have, the only decent pokers on our team is pretty much Soraka and Lucian. Poppy can't do much because she's a close combat, and Teemo, he kind of needs to get close to get that Q off. And for me, I have my E, but that really doesn't do anything, just slows them and does a little bit of damage. But my goal for this game is to just be the tank for my team, just build tanky and let my teammates do the cleanup. So I'm gonna die a couple of times here. Oh, and another reason why I'm not recording this like live and I'm just commentating over it is because I did a test. When I was recording this, and I was actually recording it live, and I was talking about how I wish the recording software that I was using would record my audio, and guess what? It didn't record my audio, and it's not because of my software, it's because my mic wasn't plugged in, and I was like, oh my god, my mic wasn't plugged in all the way. So yeah, I was pretty much just talking for no reason, and my microphone wasn't even, like, you know, plugged in. So that was annoying, but it's alright though. I decided to just keep this video and just commentate over it. So yeah, so far, most of our team are low on health right now, and that's because we're getting pressured all the way back to our tower all the time, because we have to deal with a virus Q like that, and Teemo gets knocked out, and nearly spear and Jace's shots as well. I think I die here. I don't know. Yeah, I die here. I decided to just screw it, man, because there's really nothing we can do. Like, I don't want them getting on our tower, so might as well fight. And yeah, and I want to get items, so I decided to go for Sunfire Cape first. So to, you know, to reduce that damage coming from Varus, Jace, and Kog'Maw, because I thought Kog'Maw was going to go AP, but he decided to go AD this game. And nice double kill by Lucian. Oh, check this out, guys. Look at this. Yes, bam! Good job, Human Hater. Oh, and over here, just kind of... oh my god. Soraka could have healed Kog'Maw right there. She healed him twice. I mean, once. And I didn't think that was going to save him still. So I told... That's why I type heal, because... but I did it too late. But Soraka should have healed Lucian like one more time or three more times, because she has like a full health bar. And when she did that, she could have just grabbed that health relic right there. But oh well, doesn't matter. So here we go. We got Teemo engaging on Jace, and he disengages because... Oh shit, Soraka. Oh, Soraka went for the Poro. He threw a Poro at someone and she decided to just go in. And Lucian's going in as well. And oh, we got the Poro King, right? There we go. For those of you that haven't played Poro King before, and you guys play League, you should guys play it. It's a lot of fun. It's Hollowing Abyss, except with Poro, so you get to throw Poros at people. And if you hit a maximum of 10 Poros, you get the Poro King. And he's just pretty much a big guy. Big Poro, and he's like a body, what do you call it, like a meat shield for your team. And you could use one of your summoner skills, I think over here is F, which teleports you to the Poro King. And also, when the enemy team is trying to throw Poros at you guys, that Poro King is going to suck up all the Poros, so it's not going to hit you. So yeah, and I think the Poro heals as well, I'm not sure, but if it does heal, it doesn't heal for like a lot. But anyway, so our Poro King died, and I haven't died in a while, because like I have like 1800 gold, I think. I can't really see it because I'm watching this on Sony Vegas, so yeah. So anyway, let's see over here. Soraka is about to die, so if she get hit with anything like the Varus Q or Nidalee Spear, she's... No, she got hit with an ult and she died. What the heck was that? Alright, so far so good. And... Oh boy. Varus got a triple kill, so that's not good, but I was able to... Oh no, Teemo got the kill because of his shroom. I thought I killed him, to be honest. So let's do this. So I finished my Sunfire Cape. Now I don't know what I go for here. Alright, I go for the MR because I wanted some CDR. And just to reduce that damage coming from Diana and Nidalee. Fortunately, they get our tower, but it's fine. And we haven't been able to do anything. We couldn't engage because we didn't have our ults, but now that we do, and that was my plan. To get our ults as fast as we can, and I mean we did it, but we lost our tower while doing it. So now I can engage for the team, and they'll be able to clean up. Poppy can engage as well, but Ken doesn't like engaging. To be honest, he's not building tanky. He never builds tanky. So I gotta do it. Let's see over here. Oh, I decided to ult in and I missed that ult, and I definitely die here. And yeah, so, yep, that was terrible. Oh, another reason why I'm kind of playing sloppy in here is because I'm actually trying to get used to the layout of the keyboard, mouse, and monitor setup. I'm so used to my laptop setup, and my laptop, you know, it's smaller, so it's like everything is there and I can access everything, and the screen is like on a small. And the one that I'm using is a lot bigger, larger, and the keyboard is wide, so it's like little, the space that I got is like reduced from moving my mouse, so I gotta like get used to all of that. And I'm pretty sure a couple of games of playing League, and I'll be able to get that down. So there you go, damn. So as Kog'Maw was able to kill Lucian and Soraka, Lucian died fighting. I don't know what happened to Soraka. Oh, I killed Kog'Maw. Great. Let's see, I'm 3-4, I can't remember, yeah, that's 3-4. 3-4. Now, my score is not that bad. I mean, my score is like, you know, not positive or not even. That's because I'm just playing as a tank, trying to do as much damage as I can, block as many spells, which I haven't been doing. But I don't do that. Like, I just want to get in their face, and then if they focus me, then that's going to be a problem because it's going to take a while to kill me, and then they have to worry about my teammates. So, here it goes. Jace decided to go for Lucian. He's able to kill him. And we kill him. Poro King is dying, so we decided to press F to teleport to the Poro King. Poppy kills Nidalee, so we're good. Well, I think this is. Oh, well, watch this, guys. Watch this. Knock up and a snare. And boom! Nice double kill by Soraka with assistance from Sion and Teemo. Yeah. There we go. Now we're gonna get this tower, I think. I don't think we do get it, but we'll get as much as we can on it. So this is our team advantage right now. We have the engage, and I mean Diana can engage as well, but I don't. Her engage is not as good as mine because I'm a monster, man. I'm freaking Sion, for God's sake. I freaking go attack on Titans on this guy. So let's see over here. I tried to throw a Poro King. I miss a lot of Poro Kings, man. I mean, not Poro Kings, Poro Shots. So, I'm bad at that. So far, I think we've been doing well. Like, we were losing the early game, but then as soon as we got our ultimates, we were able to fight back. They don't have a tank as well on their team. Like, yeah, they don't have, like, a tank on their team right now, so. I mean, Diana is a little bit tanky with her shield and I think she built Danya, so she got a little bit of armor, but nice kill by me right there with the ultimate. Enemy team was able to summon their Poro King, but we're still gonna go for these guys. And I was wondering why Nidalee decided not to teleport to her Poro King. That's because three of our team is killing the Poro King, and then me and Human Hater, me and Tan are trying to get this Nidalee, and she just runs away. We don't have minions, so I don't want to tank that tower because I'm gonna die. And up there goes Nidalee. No, that's Varus. Able to kill Soraka and we kill him. Great. Lucian with the kill. And here we go, he's gonna go for the Nidalee. Come on, Lucian. You could do it, man. You could do it. And boom! Killer with a Poro shot by Sion. Good job, Sion. And now I gotta move back because that's Diana. Hits you with a Q, she might probably go on you and probably kill Lucian. And I decided to drop taunting. I decided to taunt right there, and Lucian taunts with me. And it's great. Yeah, I miss playing with these guys, man. Yeah. We haven't played like in a full team in a long time. But, so there we go. So far our main damage dealer right now is Lucian. I think he has like the most kills in the game. And we have Soraka as our support, which is good, and Poppy and Teemo right there to do damage as well, and I'm just gonna be their freaking guardian. And there we go. When I was playing this, when I tried to do that axe drop right on Kava, I wanted to kill him, and freaking Ken decided to slam him through the wall and kill him, so I went down. Oh, that was funny. But wait, no, that wasn't. I killed Kava. I don't know, that champion that we killed back there, doesn't matter. He's dead. So I was able to get that. I think I decided to go in. Yeah, get her. Yeah, I decided to do a little bit of axe chop and a bit of shouting my E. And I decided to go for the tower right here. And we got the tower, so it's great. Now let's try to go for the inhib. Yeah, we're going for the inhib, man. I don't think we get it. Yeah, we don't get it. I remember this part. So, I think, yeah, I'm gonna die right here. I decided to just die by because I have like freaking 3,900 gold. So, I need to get items. And there you go. And I think I finished my spirit visage. Yeah, go for spirit. And I think I decided to go for black cleaver. Next. I like building Trinity Force on Sion when I'm doing like awesome, but Now I'm gonna try. I'm actually gonna start using Black Cleaver because, I don't know. I might as well. I mean, Sion's not like an attack speed champion or anything. And oh, the reason why I built Trinity Force before because it had like that AP, a little bit of AP, and I thought that would help me a little bit with my W and E. And but now that Trinity Force got reworked and it's all ADs, it doesn't really matter anymore. So I'll just build Black Cleaver. Oh, over here, I looked at the inhib and he had like a little bit of health left, and I told Teemo to go invisible so he could backdoor and get the inhib. So he decided to drop a shroom right there on the relic and go invisible right there. I thought that was okay, but then after, you'll see what happened to him. Diana had an Oracle extract and he got shot with bar skew and he's able to die. And yeah, he died, so I decided to engage. And I miss, cause you know, cause they're good, they know how to go right. And I got jumped on right here, but Lucian was able to save me, but I think I still die, so I just keep fighting. And yeah, you got Lucian gets a double kill, I think he gets a triple, or not, Poppy gets it, and I die. So, alright, so Teemo should have, in my opinion, I think Teemo should have chosen a better place for coming invisible, like maybe in the bush. But it doesn't matter, we still get the inhib. But we could have avoided Teemo's death there if he went to go invisible somewhere else and not like right next to the relic. But that's fine. So now I'm close to finishing my Black Cleaver. I got the Warhammer right there, so I got, I think, 25% cooldown, I believe, 10% from 10% from Spirit Vision, 10% from Warhammer, and 5% from somewhere else, I think. Maybe my runes or something. So anyway, so we got the inhib, and they still haven't gotten our tower, our second tower yet, so that's great. And this team, this game is about to be over soon. Let's see. So let's go for here. I'm just waiting. Oh, I have my ult. So I think, yeah, I'm pinging for them, and literally die. So I decided to engage right here. Perfect time to engage, and I got like two of them, and bam, axe drop right on Diana, and I decided to stick on Kog'Maw right here. Make sure he dies, and Teemo was able to get that kill, and Poppy was about to die here, but nope, her Ma was able to save her, and there we go. I think we got this game. So now I'm just gonna tank. I'm gonna die tanking for this and get the tower. I get executed, which is fine, and I think the team decided to surrender right here. So hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm sorry that I was gone for a while. But now if there's no problems, I'll be able to record and I'll go back into recording. So hope you guys enjoyed that. Take it easy. Take care. Peace out. Clydeokre out.